Hello everyone, welcome back to Minus to Millions. We're in the third day of July now, and we've got £22,410 in the bank. And what we need to do today is get this field fertilised and sown, so we're going to have to lease the equipment to do that. But before we lease a spreader, I need to check how much fertiliser we have left on the pallet, because if we don't have much, then we'll have to buy more. I think we should have enough left to do the field though, because it's only small, so we won't use much fertiliser. But if we do have to buy more, it doesn't really matter, because whatever we have left over can be unloaded onto a pallet, and then we can use it next time. So let's see what's left. Okay, there's 467 litres on the pallet, so that should be enough to do that field. And I'm going to fertilise before we begin sowing, so we need to lease a spreader first. And I'll just get the Vicon spreader that we always use, because it's cheap to lease and it has a good working width. We don't need the extension on this either, because we haven't even got enough fertiliser to fill it up with the standard configuration. So let's see how much it is to lease. Okay, it's only £175, so it's very cheap. And I'll lease the planter once we finish fertilising. So let's head over to the shop and pick up the spreader. Right, let's get this connected to the tractor, and then we can take it back, get it filled up, and begin fertilising the field. Okay, I've brought the spreader back, and I've disconnected it from the tractor so we can fill it up using the front loader, because it's a bit more realistic doing it like this, instead of just filling it up straight from the bag. And now we have this tractor, we can lift up heavy pallets, so we'll be able to fill up all our equipment like this. Okay, that's the spreader filled up, so we'll get it connected to the tractor, and then we can begin fertilising the field. And I'm pretty sure we'll have more than enough to do the field, because solid fertiliser doesn't get used very quickly. I'll have to try and make sure we're using the full working width of the spreader as well, so we won't be wasting any fertiliser. And if I line up so we're just covering the edge of the field, then we'll be getting as much of the field covered as we can. So I think around here should be good. Okay, that's pretty much perfect. And we are covering a large area of the field with this spreader, so it isn't going to take long at all to get this done. The fertiliser is going down quite slowly as well, so we might even have a few hundred litres left when we finish. If we do have some left, then I'll unload it back onto a pallet, and we can use it for the second stage of fertiliser on this field. And now I need to line up again so we're using the full working width going back up the field. So around here should be perfect. Yeah, it is. And we would have covered most of the field when we get to the end. We'll only have the small part on the right left to do. So if we can cover what's left on the way back down, we would have done this whole field by going up and down 3 times. And we'll definitely still have a few hundred litres of fertiliser left, because we haven't used much at all. So we should have enough left for the second stage of fertiliser on this field, without having to buy any more. So that's good. And we've only got the small part of the field left to do now, so hopefully we can cover all of it. I think we should be able to, because it isn't very wide, but let's see. Okay, we can get all of what's left, so once we get to the end, that will be the whole field fertilised. And we haven't used hardly any fertiliser either. I think we had about 450 litres when we started, and we've still got over 300 litres left. So we've used around 130 litres, which isn't too bad. And that's the field finished, so now we need to unload the fertiliser what we have left in the spreader. Then we can return it to the shop and lease a planter to begin sowing. And we've got 313 litres of fertiliser left, so that's more than enough to get the second stage of fertiliser on this field. So at least we haven't got to buy any more just yet, because it is quite expensive. And I'll just unload this here, then I'll put the pallet back where it was before we head up to the shop. I'm not sure how many pallets of poplar we're going to need to sow the field either, but I think I'll just get 2 to start with, because we'll be able to bring them both back at once if we load one pallet into the planter and put the other one on the pallet fork. So yeah, we'll do that. And 2 pallets might even be enough to get the field sown. But it doesn't matter if we do need more, because we've got plenty of money to buy them. And that's the fertiliser put back, so let's go and return the spreader and get a planter. I was just thinking that we might be better off keeping the spreader on lease for a few days, because we'll need to put the second stage of fertilizer on the poplar field soon. So it will probably work out much cheaper for us to keep it instead of returning it and then leasing it again. And I'll leave it up here for now and then take it back over to our land after. And that's fine there. So now we need to go and lease a planter and get some pallets of poplar. I'm not sure how much it's going to cost us for what we need, but hopefully it's not too expensive. Because like I said, I want to try and spend as little as possible on this poplar field in case we lose money again. So let's see how much this is to lease. Okay, it's £1,326 for the planter, so it is quite expensive, but we have got to get it. And now we need to get some pallets of poplar. So it's £280 for each pallet, and there's 2,000 litres on there. I thought there was only 1,000 litres on a pallet, so I might just get one for now. Yeah, I'll just get one, because we can always come back and buy more if we need to. I think 2,000 litres might be enough to sow the field though, but we'll have to see. Okay, that's the planter filled up, so let's head back and begin planting the poplar. Right, let's get started. And I've started from this side, because the other side of the field isn't completely straight. And I need to try and plant each row as straight as I can, because we'll have to leave a small gap between each row. As if they're really close together, it makes it difficult to harvest the poplar. We are turning up some stones using this planter, even though we've picked all the stones off the whole field, so I'm not sure why that's happening. It could just be where I've missed some parts of the field with the stone picker, but I don't think it is. We'll have to see how many stones get turned up over the whole field, because if we end up with lots of them, I'll have to try and remove them. I'm not sure if we'll be able to use a roller and roll them back into the soil once we've planted the poplar though, because rolling over it might destroy our poplar. And using a stone picker cultivates the soil, so that will definitely destroy it. So I don't know what we'll do, but we'll have to remove them somehow without destroying our crop. Anyway, that's the first row done, and we got it pretty straight. So now I need to line up so that we have a small gap between that row and the next one. And the poplar comes out the planter from the middle, so if I put the tractor tires close to the other row, that should be a big enough gap. So I think around there should be good. But let's see. Okay, that's fine. So now I need to keep this line straight all the way along. It doesn't really matter if every single row isn't perfectly straight and spaced out, but it would be nice if they was. And it will make it a bit easier for us when it comes to harvesting, so I'll try my best. We are doing okay so far though, but it's only the second row, so there's still plenty more to do. And it might be a bit difficult to turn around when we get up to the end, because the planter is quite long, and I can't follow the bend around like we usually do with a seeder, as we need to plant this in straight lines. I'm not sure if we'll be able to plant right to the edge of the field before we hit the rock either, but we'll have to see. It will be tight, but it looks like we might just make it. Okay, we did hit the rock, but I'm sure we got the poplar planted right to the edge. Yeah, we did, so that's good. And turning around up here is going to be a bit difficult, but once we've done this shorter part of the field and got past the rock, we won't have any problems as there's nothing in the way. But I've turned around now, and it wasn't actually too bad, and now we just need to line up the planter for the next row. So I'll make sure we're straight before we start, and I'll keep the same distance away from the poplar as we did down the other end. Then we should have the same spacing between each row. Yeah, we've got roughly the same gap between each row. We have used over 100 litres of poplar so far, and we're only on the shorter part of the field, so I think we might need to buy another pallet before we finish, because there is still a lot of the field left to do, and when we get onto the longer part, we'll be using even more poplar each row. But I think we'll only need one more pallet if we do need any more, and they're only £280, so it's not too bad. It is going to take us a while to get this field sown though, even if we don't need another pallet. So let's get it done and see if we do run out. Okay, that's the field finished, and we've still got 244 litres of poplar in the planter. So we didn't need another pallet, and we've saved a bit of money, which is good. I didn't manage to get every row perfectly spaced out or straight though, but most of them are pretty straight and well spaced out, so it shouldn't cause us any problems when we harvest. There is a lot of rocks that have been turned up though, so we'll have to try and get rid of them somehow. And we'll do that tomorrow, as it's already taken us a while to do what we've done today. But all we've got left to do now is return the planter to the shop and bring the spreader back over here. And I'll return the planter with the poplar in, because there's not much left and we aren't going to be planting poplar again for a while, and it's not worth keeping the pallet over here taking up space. So let's return this first, and then we can connect the spreader and take it back over to our land. And I'm not actually 100% sure if the pallet will disappear when we return the planter, but let's see. No, the pallet hasn't gone, so we'll have to put it on the pallet fork and take it back with us. And I'll just put it with the other pallets anyway, so it won't really be in the way. I just thought for what was left on the pallet, it wasn't really worth keeping. But I guess if we do decide to do poplar again at some point, it will save us a bit of money. And that's the pallet on the front loader, so now the last thing we need to do is connect the spreader to the tractor and take it back over to our land so that we've got it for when we put the second stage of fertilizer on the field. Okay, that's the spreader connected, and all I've got to do now is take these back over to our land. So that's everything for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, let me know by leaving a like, and feel free to subscribe so you never miss another video.